Hello guys, my name is Ayush Jain. You might know me as KP_KP. Friend takes me to play CS 1.6 in one cafe. It was WoG, War of Games. It had around 100 PCs and underground basement, and it was the first time I experienced something like that. Before that, whatever I've played, it's just Midtown Madness or Dave or something. That was my gaming life. First game or first few hours of playing CS 1.6, I was hooked. Every second day or every day after my college, which ended around 12, I used to go to cafe and I used to play almost 8 to 10 hours. I used to stay in Khargar, so it took me around 2 hours to reach college. And once I went to my college, after that I used to come home around 12 in the night. My mom used to ask me, ki kya karta rehte itne din pura din. My mom's studying. It's college life and I'm studying and I'm just trying to know everything and what's going on and what's not going on. She never came to know I'm playing. Met some guy named Moin. You might know him as Friction. So I was just hooked at his playing, you know, it was so quick and so his reflexes were so good. So we came to in touch with Aza because he used to play in Bashi and I used to stay in Khargar. And he used to know a few of the friends who come in the cafe where occasionally every weekend they used to have an IPL sort of thing where 50 people used to come around at 8 a.m. in the morning and we used to play CS. So the teams were random, there'll be like 5 captains or 6 captains and there'll be a proper auction of players. Obviously I was the last because I just started a month back. So from 1 to 9 for almost 3 years, this was my life playing CS 1.6. Slowly and slowly I started playing good and you know giving time. The bad effect was like obviously it affected my studies. But then in the end, I used to lie about home ki, you know, I'm studying. And my this results never hampered. So sort of was okay. But then the biggest thing came was my CA papers. So that time I knew I had to study. And my mom was like, college band karo, tumko jana nahi, tum ghar pe baith ke padho. And those 6 months, I didn't play anything. I was just sitting home every day dreaming ki, I could rush a shot or I could have done this or next time when we play, this could be our strat. And slowly my college got over, I did my CA papers and all those. And then suddenly I come to know this. A new game which is called Counter-Strike Global Offensive. So there was one just random ass day ki the Veer Bhadra calls me up and like your friend is my friend also, if you play just come with me, I'll take you there and you know you can see what's going around. So there was the first time I met team 3GP, I think Juventa, A-Star, Pawn. That was the first time I met them. I didn't know who they are first of all. Later on when people start talking, they told me ki, yeah, they are professional players who are, you know, they have a team called Brutality, like it came into existence later on. First it was 3GP, I guess. So I was just sitting there for almost 6 hours. You won't believe I was standing there just watching the game. There was one night also, I was just standing behind them and they're playing for the whole night. I was like, dude, this is something I want to try and I want to give it a try for it. I did try, I failed badly. So I used to sit behind, just standing, watching the game whole night. It was like almost a week I was going every night, every day for night outs, just to watch the games. They used to play internationally also, like, I don't know, some foreign servers or something. I had no clue what it is. The biggest advantage I got is like, when I used to play in college, my college group was different. They were filthy rich. So our LP, loser's pay, used to be around 10, 15 or 20K. So one randomized, I had a fight with some friend. He's like, tu apni team lekar aa. That time I got Juventa, A-Star, Veer Bhadra and I think two from Bhandup. I don't know, I still don't remember. And it was a 25-50k battle. So whoever loses 25k and they just finished them in two maps. 16, I still remember the score, 16-4 and 16-7. So I was like, okay, this could be done, this is a good business. And you know, they used to challenge them every weekend. He, at least there will be some time, you know, they'll win. And finally, after two LPs, Juventa was like, you can play. Like, we don't have player anymore, come you play. I was shit scared. I was trembling for the first 10 rounds. I was like, okay, I'm going to lose, so I'll go with my money. But then somehow they managed and they won and I was really happy. And after that, there was a long gap. Parents got to know, okay, this is what's going on because I never used to carry so much money. And suddenly I had around 20K in my wallet and lying down around. So they questioned me what's going on, kidhar se aa raha hai, kya aa raha hai. So I was frank, I just told him ki we used to play and it used to be loser's pay or something like that and we won. And that was the time my dad just slapped me once. And it just shook me for like 10 seconds, like later on, theek hai. Next day again I was playing the same thing. So this is what happens, like I think every gamer faces through this thing. But again, after 2015, again Vinay calls me up and like, we should try, there's some new game in the market, CS:GO, and I tried, and by 2 or 3 months it took me to just understand what the game is, because I didn't buy the game. I already had an ID from someone else. It was, I think, Steam ID or something. I was in Khargar and there was no cafe for CSGO particularly, and Global Gaming Cafe in Vashi opened, and in my group only I was allowed to drive. So I remember I used to take me, myself, Shinchan, Monster, Mantri for night directly from Khargar to Vashi for night outs and play CS. It's there where I learned something, but then also my name got very bad as I used to bait everyone. I never had any confidence in my shooting. So even if I was the first person to rush inside, I'll be the last person to go inside. And everyone used to shout at me, ki kya bait kar raha hai, kya bait kar raha hai. But theek hai, it happens. I was not that confident. Even though many a times I felt that I should have a team that time, but then obviously it's Indian CSGO, friendship is more important than game. And this is a time where I literally had some confidence, and the shift which I was so fond of, I left, finally let go of my shift. Right now I cannot hold. I just want to rush everywhere and try to kill everyone. So this is a part of my gaming life which has been changed since I shifted. Obviously, influence matters. Even though I never had a professional team, or I did give a lot of efforts to get into something or try to something, but bad luck or something, but it happens. You should have someone to look after you and tell you how to improve. And that's what happened to me. I have few people who literally gave me time and told me, if you do this, you'll be good. If you don't do this, you won't be good. Like, never bait anyone. That's the first thing. Right now, if someone said, pehle it used to be, if someone used to tell me beta, I used to feel happy. Right now, it's like, theek hai. If you tell me, just come next time, I'll show you what happens to you. So this is the transition you'll see from just a guy from a normal family who went to college for some studies, and then you come to some esports games, and how life changed. And I think the biggest part which changed in my life was YouCypher. For our parents, basically, to tell them that it is something which is really good. So YouCypher bought something in our television, basically. There was nothing like in television before. I think right now the biggest question is LAN versus online. It's a really good question. I've personally seen a lot of things, because I remember being with a very bad team, or like I'll say average team. We went to Pune for some Acer qualifier or some Asus qualifiers, and we were facing 2EZ in the finals. The main 2EZ core, which had, I think, Rex, Tito, Mantri and Shinchan, the main 2EZ, which were amongst top 4 ranking in India. And we almost beat them, because what me, Tapan and Varun and Striker noticed is that Tito was shivering. His hands were like, very shaky and all those things. So we just noticed that, and we like, wherever Tito's, we'll go there. And we literally beat them. It's just our bad luck, or you might say something happened, the server crashed, and the momentum we just lost the momentum, and they gained the momentum. So I still feel ki there's a big difference when you play on LAN, because you are not accustomed to that PC. First of all, when you're sitting at home, you are at home, very comfort. Like, theek hai, what will happen? Even if you do a goof up, no one's gonna tell you what you did. But when you're on LAN, you have 3 or 4 people beside you, and then 10-15 people watching you in front of you, and then people, your opponents are shouting. And if they come to know that you're weak at somewhere, they'll exploit you. So that's the biggest thing right now. What Indian culture is right now, ki main ghar pe baitha main maar dunga sabko. But when they come to LAN, when they face sub level PCs, like right now the PCs have improved a lot for many tournaments, but when I was playing, we had around 75Hz monitor or 144Hz monitor with 200fps or 150fps. It's all good for me, because I've played in cafe, I'm used to it, but then many people are used to 500 or 600fps. And for them, it was like, nahi jam raha mere ko, ye nahi jam. They'll start, the biggest pointer for to know whether someone's nervous or not, he'll start changing the color of his keyboard, or try to do anything except just talking about the game. They know they are guilty or conscious, and they don't know how to play, or they have just goofed up something big. So you'll come to know what's going on. And the biggest thing is, when you're on LAN, it's the pressure that you feel. It's just like, if you play cricket in a ground and in net, there's a big difference. In net, you can hit 100 sixes and a go. But when you come in ground, and when there's excitement, there's fielders talking trash to you, and that comes, it's the same feeling when you're on LAN. In nets, you won't come to know what happens around. There's a bowler and you're playing. Online is the same. You see an enemy, you kill it. But when you're actually in a LAN, and there's a pressure about all the people you're playing with, and the opponents and the team you're supporting, like the crowd and who the team is supporting, it creates a huge difference. And I really feel right now the LAN culture in India is gone. 1.6 was really good because I remember people used to come at 8 a.m. in the morning to play. I know that. I felt that even the professional players of that time used to come at 8 a.m. in the play. I remember I used to come with Friction. He used to stay in Vashi, I used to stay in Kharga, and we used to go to Grand Road to play. That's almost 40 kilometers from where we stay. So right now, even it's like, you know, you have to plan a weekend that, you know, today we'll play. That too, in that day, someone is going to cancel it. Which is very wrong. And this culture of, you know, ghar pe to sab raja hi hota hai. Bahar aayenge to pata chalega wo log kya karte kya nahi karte. And it happens. For the first time, when you have those cameras in front of you, anyone's going to shiver. You later on develop it. And when you're just sitting at home, it's chill, it's your home, yaar. Tumko kya hi kuch bolne wala. What MESC is doing right now, it's really good. Because again, as I said, ki when we had IPL on Sundays, it's almost the same. It's just that it's in very large scale. The prize pool is large. The IPL, which we used to play for 1.6, was just for fun. And that everyone used to, get a chance to play. MESC is good because right now, even though India has around 50, 60 or 70 or 100 odd professionals who've represented in India or done something or it's been consistent, it's players who are unknown. Like right now also, I feel there are few teams that have tried with new players. Like recently the biggest discovery was Karamil. No one knew about him much and suddenly just came to rise. Before that it was Master and before that was Tito. They just start playing LANs and they start playing somewhere else and people just took them up. And for this also, if you have two professionals, it's a guide also for the people. I had many people as my guides who helped me around. And this way, upcoming professional who's around 16, 17 years of age and is dedicated and really plays good, it's really good. And the opportunity which she's going to get is really good. Because they'll come to know what communication goes on, what the mindset on what the process these professional players have in their mind. And it really changes them. Right now, if someone asks me ki, if I want to start CS, I'll preferably say him ki, first of all, just sit, roam around the map, understand the map, feel the map, then start shooting. It's not just about shooting. There was a time in India where it was just about shooting. Okay, he's a good aimer, he's gonna kill everyone. But right now, the CS has changed such, the global offense has changed such, you have to have a coordination. Like, you cannot be, it's not a sole main game. You have five players to do a particular job. It's not easy. And this scene is going to help the upcoming players.